communication channel wise, in terms of PMP exam perspective, you may or may not get question on the communication channel, but you should know how to calculate the communication channel, because it's relatively very easy compared to any mathematical question. So in case if you are lucky and getting any question on communication channel, at least you will solve it confidently. You can secure one question, right? So let's see some questions based on that. But before calculating communication channel, know some techniques, because in the communication channel also we have so much confusion. Sometimes we do include project manager, sometimes we don't include. Most often people are confused in that situation, whether they should include the project manager or should not. So let's see some techniques before practicing some question. Case one, your project has 10 members, including the project manager. This is type of scenario. Two more team members added, removed to the project team. So here n is 12. If you are adding 10 members, including the project manager, so there is no confusion here in this type of scenario, because it is already clearly stating that project manager is included in it. Now on top of that, further it is telling you in the question that you can consider any of the scenario, either adding or removing. I have just written here both. So added, removed to the project. So now what would be total stakeholders in this project? Earlier it was 10, here you see including the project manager. Now if you are considering adding, then it would be 12. If you are considering removing, then it would be 8, right? So if this is the scenario, you don't have any confusion whether you should include the project manager or not. You simply, you can see here project manager is included, and this is your n given the numbers of a stakeholder, and you can simply calculate the number of communication channels. This is the scenario two. It is telling you, you are interacting with 9 other stakeholders, means you as a project manager. So in this scenario, you have to include yourself, 1, you and 9 other stakeholders. So total you need to consider here n, 10, and then you have to calculate the communication channels. You have a team of 5, developer and tester. One team member moved to another project. In this example, n is 5. Initially n was 6, including 5 developers and tester, and you need to include yourself in this count of n. So in this scenario, you are including yourself. 5 developer and tester, they are your team member. So 5 they are and 1 you, so total 6. But one team member has moved to another project, it is stated here. So in this case, here including 5 developer and tester, and you need to include yourself in this count of n. So this is another scenario, so don't need to confuse in this scenario also, because here it is clearly saying you have a team of developer and tester. So whatever numbers of developer and tester plus you need to include. Then case 4, there are only 8 stakeholders on the project. In this scenario, project manager is already. Here you see there are only 8 stakeholders. So it is not specifically talking about team members, talking about project manager. It is as a whole talking about stakeholders in the project. So here in this scenario, project manager is already included. So you have to consider n is equal to 8. You don't have to add one more as a project manager. So these are some cases you have to keep in your mind when you are reading the question based on the communication channel calculation. And this is the formula, n minus 1 divided by 2. So let's see some questions based on that. You are managing a project with 10 team members. How many lines of communication do you have on your project? So I think you guys can calculate it. It's simple. So do it and send your answer. So right answer is B here. And what is the keywords in this? You are managing a project with 10 team members. So what you will be doing here? You are considering 10 plus you are including yourself. So there would be 11. N would be 11. And then you are going to put it on the formula. So this will give you the answer B. Here you can see number of people 10 plus 1 including the project manager. So this is giving you answer 55. Next question here. There are only 5 stakeholders on the project. 5 more stakeholders are added. How many new channels have been added? So you have to understand this question. First, it is asking only 5 stakeholders on the project. 5 more stakeholders are added. How many new channels? So first you have to calculate for the old stakeholders. Then you have to add new members with the old, and then you have to calculate new members channels and to subtract old channels from the total, and that would be your answer. So here you can see old stakeholders. This is giving you 10. This was initial communication channel when you had 5 stakeholders. Then calculate as a whole with added stakeholders. So later on 5 stakeholders added to the project also. So 5 old plus 5 new, now 10. So if you place on the formula, it will give you 45. So now you need to know how many communication channel has been added new. So for that, you need to subtract 45 minus 10. This will be giving you 35. Another scenario here, you have 12 members in your team, including you. So here clearly stating in the question that including you, there are total 12 members. 5 members left the team and later you got only 3 replacements. 5 left and later in place of 5, you only got 3. Okay, so 12 minus 5 plus 3. This is the N. How many channels you have now? So this is how you have to calculate. So here you can see total number of communication channels before the member left, 12, 12 minus 1 divided by 2. So this will be giving you 66 before members are left. And then current number of members, 12 minus 5 plus 3. So this is 5 left and 3 added. So this is the new status. So with this, you are getting 45. Right, and this is what you have to calculate, how many communication channels currently you have. So correct answer is 45. All right, so this we have completed, guys. Communication channels, how you can calculate.